Saying good morning to everyone. Today is a special day. It is the day when we commemorate the death of Jesus Christ. And as we reflect upon his life today, I want to encourage us to worship him, not to be sad that he died, but to give him the true worship that he deserves. I welcome all of you. I welcome all of you, and I thank you for coming. And this morning, as we gather to worship, we are going to be operating under the theme, a demonstration of love that deserves our worship. Jesus's death on the cross was a demonstration of love which deserves our worship. Let's all stand as we bow our heads in prayer. O God and our Father, we give you thanks for this day. Indeed, we rejoice in the fact that it is the day that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for sending your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into the world to become the Savior of the world. We thank you for the redemption plan that you put in place so that all of us, the whole world, can be saved. We thank you for your Holy Spirit who draws us to you. And when we accept and believe, he lives inside us to guide us, to teach us, to lead us in the way that we should go. We welcome your presence among us, Holy Spirit. Have your way in this service. Lord, let your will be done. Be glorified in and through our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The worship team will come at this time. We are going to sing, He alone is worthy to worship and adore.
He alone is worthy to be worshipped and adored. The Lamb of God, victorious, arisen Lord. He purchased my redemption. My righteousness is in him. Exalt the name of Jesus, he is worthy. He alone is worthy to worship and adore. The Lamb of God, victorious, arisen Lord, he purchased my redemption. All righteousness, exalt the name of Jesus. He is worthy
alone.
He alone is worthy to be worshipped and adored. The Lamb of God, victorious, arisen Lord. He purchases our redemption. Our righteousness is He. Exalt the name of Jesus. He is worthy.
Just sing it one more time. He alone.
He alone is worthy to worship and adore.
The Lamb of God,
victorious, He purchased my redemption. My righteousness is free. Exalt the name of Jesus. He is worthy. He exalt the name. Exalt the name of Jesus. He is worthy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thou art worthy. Thou art worthy. Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory, glory and honor,
glory and honor and power.
For thou hast
created, as all things created,
yes,
thou hast created all things.
But your God who is worthy,
though thou art worthy, O Lord, thou art worthy, O
Created. Yes, Thou Lord, You are worthy. You alone, You alone, You alone are worthy. Thou are worthy, oh Lord. To receive glory,
glory and honor, and
our power. Things were created for Him to bring honor and glory unto Him. We could honor Him this morning because He was the one who bore all our sins, all our pain, all our pressure. All. It was my cross He bore so I could live. In the freedom You died for,
and life is Yours,
and I will sing of Your goodness forever. It was my cross. It was my cross You bore. So I could live in the freedom You died for, and now my life is Yours, and I will sing of Your goodness forevermore. Worthy is Your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is Your name. Worthy is Your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is Your name. And now my fame is gone. I stand amazed in Your love undeniable. Your grace goes on and on, and I will sing of Your goodness forevermore. Worthy is Your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is Your name.
praise. What is your name?
Verse 2.
Now my ship is gone, and I'm the best. In your love for me,
your grace works on and on, and I will sing of your goodness forevermore. What is your name, Jesus? You deserve the praise. What is your name? What is your name? Jesus, you deserve the praise. What is your name? Be exalted now in the heaven. As we know, we feel this place. You alone deserve the praise. You're the name above all names. Be exalted now in the heaven. As your glory fill this place. You alone deserve our praise. You're the name above all names. Be exalted now in the heaven, as your glory fills this place. You alone deserve the praise. You're the name above all names. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Hallelujah.
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 He alone is worthy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let's sing this song. When I survey the wondrous cross, this one I don't know so well, so I will need some help with it.
When I survey the wondrous cross, on which the Prince of Glory died, my riches gained are but loss, and forgotten for all my pride. Forbid it not that I should boast, save in the death of Christ my Lord. All the things that charge me most, I sacrifice them to the blood. See, for in death his hands is faith. So the floor being good, he gets the job and sorrow made. All the comfort of each and one, where the whole of nature mine, that were the present far too small. Love so amazing, so divine, deep in my soul, my life, my Lord.
Imagine there are some old songs that you haven't sung them so long that it's like you don't even remember them. But let's sing this one to our Lord. Hallelujah. It's a song.
Hallelujah.
Oh, did I forget that one? It's a song that I love. In Christ alone.
In Christ alone, my hope is found.
He is my light, my strength, my throne. This cornerstone, this solid ground. Walk through the fire,
doubt and storm.
What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fear has striving cease. My comfort, my all in all, hearing the love of Christ, I sing in Christ alone, the hope of death. Fullness of God in heaven's name, this gift of love and righteousness, come by the one he came to see. Hail on the cross that Jesus died, the God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, hearing the gift of Christ at him. There is the ground his body laid, light of the world by God's sin, then bursting forth in glorious day. Up from the grave he rose again, and as he stands in the victory, since Christ has lost his will and name. For I am his and he is mine, bought by the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me, whom life first cried to final death. Jesus demands my best in me, the power of hell, the skin of blood. What is it till he returns? I'm caught in you. Here is the power of God, I said, till he returns, I'm caught in you. Here is the power of God.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Let's just worship the Lord. Open your mouth. Give him thanks. Give him praise. He deserves our worship. He deserves our praise. He deserves our thanksgiving. Hallelujah. 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 You may be seated. This morning, as I said earlier, we are operating under the theme, a demonstration of love that deserves our worship. And when Jesus Christ, just before he went to the cross, he did some things that he wants us to remember. And as we follow through in this service, there are three parts to this service, and I have asked some of the persons, the leaders, to assist me with this service today. So at this time, we are going to call on Sister Gracia, and she will be dealing with the feet washing aspect of this service. Let's welcome her as she comes, please.
Good morning, church. I'm going to read a scripture from St. John's chapter 13, verses 1 to 17. This is about Jesus washes his disciples' feet. It was just before the Passover feast. Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The evening meal was in progress, and the devil had already tempted Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Lord had put all things under his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. So he got up from the meal, took off his outer clothing, and wrapped a towel around his waist. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet, drying them with the towel that was wrapped around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus replied, "You do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand." "No," said Peter, "you shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no part with me." Then Lord, said Simon Peter, "Not my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus answered, "Those who have had a bath need only to wash their feet. Their body is clean, and you are clean, though not every one of you." For he knew who was going to betray him, and that was why he said not everyone was clean. When he had finished washing their feet, he put on his clothes and returned to his place. "Do you understand what I have done for you?" he asked them. "You called me teacher and Lord, and rightly so. For that is what I am." In the scriptures, you realize that God had given Jesus the power to do anything, but Jesus wanted to show humility and self-love. He didn't have to wash anybody's feet. He could have asked somebody to wash their feet, or get a servant to wash the feet. He had all the power. He was the master of everything in the world. But yet, he humbled himself and he washed his disciples' feet. Just an example for what he wants us to do in this world, to be humble and show self-love. We are going to pray. So, before we pray, we are going to sing just the chorus: "Jesus Messiah, name above all name, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel." Jesus Messiah, name above all names,
blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all.
One more time, please. Jesus Messiah,
Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the ransom for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all.
Let us pray. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, Father God, please show us how to love people like you loved us. When we are selfish, make us humble. When we are eager to serve, please transform our hearts and to treat others with humility. We ask these things in your name. Amen. The floor is now open for the washing of feet. The ladies may sit on this side for the washing of feet and the men on this side for the washing of feet. So you can choose someone and you come. It's your choice. It's not. Thank you.
Ask the Lord as you come this morning who he wants you to serve. This is about humility. This is about service. Thank you. Whiter than the snow, whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than the snow. Please help me sing if you are not praying. Whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than the snow, whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be white than snow. Whiter than the snow. Whiter than the snow. Oh, wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Thorny was the crown that he wore, and the cross his body o'ercame. Grievous were the sorrows he bore, but he suffered thus not in vain. May I to that fountain be led, may to cleanse my sins there below. Wash me in the blood that he shed, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than the snow. Whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Father, I have wandered from thee, often has my heart gone astray. Crimson do my sins seem to me, water cannot wash them away. May I to that fountain of thine, may to cleanse my sins here below. Cleanse me by thy washing divine, and I shall be whiter than
whiter than the snow. Whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than the snow. Whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Father, I have wandered from thee. Often has my heart gone astray. Crimson do my sin seem to me. Water cannot wash them away. Jesus, to the fountain of thine, leaning on thy promise I go. Oh, cleanse me by thy washing divine, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than the snow. Whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than the snow. Whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be white. Let's sing that verse again. Father, I have wandered, Father, I have wandered from thee. Often has my heart gone astray. Crimson do my sin seem to me. Water cannot wash them away. Jesus, to the fountain of thine, leaning on thy promise I go. Cleanse me by thy washing divine, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than the snow. Whiter than the snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. We are going to now have Sister Mary come, and she's going to sing for us, "How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure." Let's welcome her as she comes, please.
Good morning, church. Good morning, church. How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of sin lost, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mother chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon a cross, by sin upon his shoulders. Ashamed I hear my mocking voice fall out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there, until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished. I will not boast in anything. No gifts, no power, no wisdom. But I will boast in Jesus Christ, his death and resurrection. Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot give an answer. But this I know with all my heart, his wounds have paid my ransom. How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of sin lost, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mother chosen one bring many souls to glory. How great the pain of sin lost, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mother chosen one bring many sons to glory.
Amen, 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 amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Sister Mary. Indeed, when we consider how deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he would come for you and I and give his son
as a treasure. Amen. We are going to call on Sister Yvette, who also will lead us in the communion area. Sister Yvette.
Good morning, church. Our scripture reading this morning for the communion is taken from St. Matthew chapter 26, reading verse 23 to 29. St. Matthew chapter 26, verse 26 to 29. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of it. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say unto you, I will not drink hence therefore of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." Thank you, Lord. Our second scripture reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 to 29. "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body which was broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' After the same manner also he took the cup, when he had supped, saying, 'This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me.' For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he comes. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body." Today, I'm asking all of us who will partake in the Lord's Supper to please stand, and you may come forward. Please come forward. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died upon the cross. As we come to this table today, may we trust in your righteousness and mercy. We thank you for Jesus' sacrifice on the cross, and we ask your blessings on this bread and wine that represents your body, has broken your body, and this blood healed from every sickness and diseases. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us all take our bread. Hold it up. And he also took the bread and he broke it and blessed it and gave thanks. Let us all eat together. And in the same manner, he took the cup and he blessed it and he poured it to us that we may do it as often as we should. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us all eat together. Father, I give you thanks for us, your people. Help us in obedience, Lord, to honor your word and honor your name, and live according to your word. In Jesus, we give you thanks and praise. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sister Yvette. At this time, we are going to invite Sister Brenda to sing for us, "Thank You, Jesus, for the Blood Applied."
Morning, church.
I was a wretch. I remember who I was. I was lost. I was blind. I was running out of time. Sin separated, the breach was far too wide. But from the far side of the chasm, you held me in your sight. So you made a way across the great divide, left behind heaven's throne to build it here inside. And there at the cross, you paid the debt I owe, broke my chains, freed my soul. For the first time I had hope. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Thank you, Jesus, you have saved my life, brought me from the darkness into glorious light. you took my place, laid inside my tomb of sin. You were buried for 3 days, but then you walked right out again. And now death has no sting, and life has no end. For I have been transformed by the blood of the Lamb. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Thank you, Jesus, you have saved my life, brought me from the darkness into glorious light. There is nothing stronger than the wonder-working power of the blood. The blood that calls us sons and daughters. We are ransomed by our Father through the blood. The thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Thank you, Jesus, you have saved my brought me from the darkness into glorious light. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Thank you, Jesus, you have saved my life, brought me from the darkness into glorious light. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. There to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to his name.
Amen, amen. Thank you very much, Sister Brenda. Indeed, we are to thank the Lord for his blood that was applied. We're going to invite Sister Deslin to give us some scriptures for the crucifixion. Let's welcome her as she comes, please.
Good morning, church. Here are our scriptures for the crucifixion. Isaiah 53, verse, firstly, two scriptures, Isaiah 53, verses 1 to 12, And then I'll be reading another one from St. Matthew. Isaiah 53, verse 1 to 12. Who hath believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he openeth not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment. And who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living, for the transgression of my people was he stricken. And he made his grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He has put him to grief. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see of the travail of his soul, and shall be satisfied. By his knowledge shall my righteous servant justify many, for he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore will I divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he hath poured out his soul unto death, and he was numbered with the transgressors, and he bare the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors. That was the first scripture reading. And the second one is taken from Matthew chapter 27. Verse 29 to 46. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand, and they bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews! And they spit upon him, and took the reed and smote him in the head. And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him and put his own raiment on him and led him away to be crucified. And as they came out,
they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. Him they compelled to bear the cross. And when they were coming to a place called Golgotha, that is to say, a place of skull, they gave him vinegar to drink, mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. And they crucified him and parted his garments, casting lots that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And sitting down, they watched him there. And set up over his head his accusation written, "This is the King of the Jews." Then were there two thieves crucified with him, one on the right and the other on the left. And they that passed by reviled him, wagging their heads and saying, "Thou that destroyest the temple and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself. If thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross." And likewise also the chief priests, mocking him with the scribes and the elders, "He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of the Jews, let him now come down from the cross, and then we will believe him. He trusted in God, let him deliver him now, if he will have him, for he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" And the thieves also, which were crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now, from the sixth hour, there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Here endeth the scripture reading.
Thank you very much, Sister Deslyn. We have heard the word of God come to us this morning, starting from the Passover, where Jesus washed the disciples' feet and introduced what we call communion, or the Last Supper. We went through the process this morning, and we are now at the place where Jesus was crucified. I want you to close your eyes. Imagine with me Jesus. People are mocking him. They spit in his face. They gambled for his garment. They said to him, "You saved others, yourself you cannot save." At that point in time, Jesus, the Son of God, became all man. When he bore the weight of the sin upon him, he cried out, "My God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" The reason Jesus did all of that was because He loved you and he loved me to such an extent that he was willing to give his life. Today, he is asking us one question. Since I have given my life for you, are you willing to live for me? With your heads bowed and your eyes closed, I invite you to talk to the Lord. Many times we don't need a sermon. We just need to be obedient. Let us pray. Right where you are, talk to the Lord in prayer. O God and our Father, we thank you for this opportunity you've given to us to be alive and to be able to gather here, to take a moment to reflect upon the sacrifice that Jesus made on our behalf. Lord, we recognize that it was because of love. It wasn't our sins that held him on the cross, but it was his love for us why he stayed there. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for loving us with an everlasting love. Thank you, Jesus, that you allowed your blood to be shed so that we can have eternal life. Thank you, Lord. Today, we give you thanks and we give you praise. And we ask that you will help us to give you the honor and the glory that you deserve. For someone who has demonstrated such love to us, the least that we can do is to give you the highest honor. Search our hearts today, Lord. Cleanse us from every sin and unrighteousness. And help us as we continue to reflect upon your sacrifice for us, that, Lord, we will let your will be done in us, or here on earth, as it is in heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let's all stand. We are going to sing this chorus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. And let us really give him thanks this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. You went to Calvary and you died for me. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. You went to Calvary and you died for me. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. You went to Calvary. You went to Calvary. And you died for me. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. You went to Calvary and you died for me. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. minutes, just open our mouth and give the Lord thanks for loving us. Hallelujah. Tell him thanks this morning. Give him what he deserves, our worship. It's a personal thing this morning. It's not the sister or the brother, the person who is standing next to you. It's you giving God thanks. You're giving him the worship that he deserves. You deserve it, Lord. You deserve our worship. You deserve our praise. You deserve our thanksgiving, Lord. Nothing less, nothing less. You deserve it, Lord. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. Lord, you deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it, Lord. You deserve it. You gave your all for us, Lord. You deserve our worship. You deserve our worship, our praise, and our thanksgiving. Lord, nobody else, nobody else, nobody else, Lord. Nobody else. Nobody else, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. You went to Calvary and you died for me. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. You went to Calvary. And you died for me. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are going to bring our offering. We are going to bring our offering this morning. Whatever offering you have to give to the Lord this morning, you're going to bring it. And we know that we can't pay the Lord for what he has done for us. But whatever we give, let us give it unto the Lord with grateful hearts, saying, Lord, I can't pay you, but I'm giving you something today, this special day. This special day, when we commemorate your death, I'm giving something to you. I'm giving something good. Give him what you have. And we are going to sing this song, King of My Life, I Crown You Now. King of My Life, he will take our monies, but more than that, he needs our lives. So as we come and we give our offerings, we are going to sing King of My Life. King of my life, I crown thee now. Thine shall the glory be. Lest I forget thy thorn crown bow, lead me to God. Oh, lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me, lead me to God. Show me the tomb where thou wast laid, tenderly mourned and wept. Angels in robes of light arrayed, guarded thee whilst thou slept. Lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me, lead me to Calvary. Let me like Mary through the gloom come with a gift to thee. Show to me now the empty tomb, lead me to Calvary. Oh, lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me, lead me to Calvary. May I be willing, Lord, to bear daily my cross for thee. Even thy cup of grief to share,
thou hast borne all for me. Oh, lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me. Pity, glory. Oh, lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thy love for me. Lest I forget thy love for me. Pity, glory. Oh, lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me. Lead me to Calvary, lest I forget thy love for me, lest I forget thy love for me. Lead me to Calvary, lest I forget, lest I forget thy love for me. Lead me to Calvary. Amen. You may be seated. I pray today that the Spirit of the Lord has ministered to each and every one of us individually and collectively.